The average professional spends over 28% of their time managing emails. That's nearly 11 hours per week. Imagine what you could accomplish if you could cut that time in half. In today's video, I'll reveal how automating your Outlook inbox can save you hours and boost your productivity. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Let's jump right in. The first tip I want to give you to manage your Outlook more effectively is making sure that you have your focus inbox turned on. Right now, notice it just says inbox. I'm going to go up to the menu up top, go under View, View Settings, and under Mail here, I'm going to go to Focused Inbox, choose the account that you want to apply this to. I'm going to click Sort Message into Focused Another. Click Save, I'm closing out, and now notice I have Focused and Other. So right now it went through and divided this between the two different ones. You can customize this as you go along too. So if you look into others, if there's ones that you wanted to be in focused, you could categorize them or simply right click and then we can move them into different places, different tabs that would recognize, but we can also move to focused inbox or always move to focus inbox. And this will help it even learn better to keep you organized. My next time-saving tip is to take advantage of Quick Steps. I'm under the Home tab, and if you take a look in the ribbon, we'll go across and we have Quick Steps right here. I have one Quick Step. I'm going to make a brand new one. This was to follow up on meeting. I'm going to go and drop down, and we're going to go and manage Quick Steps. So once you click this, you're in a spot where you can create your new Quick Step, and I'm just going to go select this. Let's start by giving this a name, and I'm just going to call this Move and Forward It. So I want to take this email, move it to a different folder, and have it forwarded to someone else. And those are kind of just random actions, but you can add a lot of different ones. So choose my action. If I drop down here, you can see all the different actions here. The one I want to do first is Move To. Where do I want it to have be moved to? If I drop down, you can see the different options. I could create a brand new folder. I'm going to just search for a folder I already have created called Demo. I'm going to go ahead and add another action now. So if I drop down and take a look at the list, you're going to see Forward right here and all the different other options. I'm going to say Forward To. Who do I want this forwarded to? Well, I'll just pick this email right here. And I could add more if I wanted to. I could go ahead and remove this, these different steps or these different actions as well. And I could keep adding more actions. What I like is there's also a shortcut to be even more efficient. So if I drop down here, you see the different options. I'll just choose this Control-Shift-5. And once all done, hit Save. And you notice it popped up right over here. So if I wanted this to be the top one, if I have lots of them, just change the order here. So if I move the quick step up, now this becomes the top one. I can go back and edit these or delete them from here. So if I go ahead and just exit out here and I'm in my inbox, let's go ahead and apply it to this one. So let's say I have this Microsoft one. I could go ahead and click on this. So notice it's moved out of here. So where did it go? Well, if I take a look at Demo over here, notice it's in draft here because if I go to edit it, I could go ahead and write a quick note and send it from here. So it didn't send it out. So I could go ahead and add a quick note and it's to the right person that I pick, but then I could go ahead and hit send. And remember, the other option was to use the shortcut. So if I just said this one, I could use the Control-Shift-5. And just like that, it's going to be in the same place of the demo. And we're going to have it in here. You can see there's the other draft here as well. So take advantage of quick steps and getting things done faster in Microsoft Outlook. Here's another big time-saving tip in Outlook, and that's using templates. So if you're sending the same email over and over again, you can use a template to speed this up. I'm going to click New up top here, and as soon as I do that, you'll notice that we have the Message tab. I'm going to move over to Apps, and I already have my templates here, but if you don't, you'll find it here. And this is where you can pin or unpin it, and then it's going to show up right here. So as soon as I click on this, now, Microsoft already put a few in here, and this is how quick they are to use. So if I was going to say this one, I can click on it. It gets added to the email right away. At any time, if you want to change these or delete these, just go ahead and click the delete or use the edit template, and you can change whatever you want. So in this one, if you wanted to add maybe a bit longer template, what I would do is, and if you know you're using it over and over again, I would start an email and get it how you have it, how you wanted to have it looking in here. You could add any attachments. You could change the color on any of these. So if I just quickly, just to show you a little bit of a demo here, and if I was going to put an attachment in here as well, so let's just pick this Excel practice sheet. This could be now, if I go ahead and copy this, Control C, go back to my template, paste it in here, and I'm just going to call this demo, hit save. So notice it's in there with this and everything. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this, discard this message, and let's go ahead and create a new message. And if I go up top, we have my templates because I've pinned it here. Click on it, and here's my demo one that I have here. So it shows me here's the other ones here. If I click on it, it goes right inside here. So it's even giving the attachment here. It's giving the formatting that I added to this. And you can make it look any way you want and then copy paste it over. This can be a real time saver. This next tip for organizing your email is a quick one, but often overlooked. Let's use this email as an example. If you look up at the Home tab and inside the ribbon, we're going to move to Sweep. So Sweep quickly will make a rule around the selected email authors. So since I have that email selected, if I select Sweep, it will come up with this message. It shows me for who the email is from and what rule it will apply. So it makes a very quick way. So if you want to, let's say, always move messages older than 10 days from the inbox folder and move to where? So I could say create my own. In this case, we'll do an example. Let's call this demo 2, and I'm going to click save. Let's go ahead and hit OK. So notice now I could view my rules. I'm just going to hit OK, but it cleaned up a lot of my emails here. If I look at demo 2, it has those 7 different emails that I was quickly able to organize. Now, I could have chosen to delete these as well. That's part of the rules that you get to make up for yourself. This next tip is a very powerful tip. It's how you can filter incoming emails with a rule. Now, I've kind of showed you with Sweep how it creates a rule, very simple rule. This will allow you to have some more customization. So in this case, I'm getting these Microsoft invoices. I just want them to automatically, let's say, go into a folder when they get into my inbox. So I can go up and create a rule by choosing Rule, Manage Rules, and I can go choose the account that this will be part of and click Add New Rule. Now, just like before, we give it a name, and I'm just going to call this Demo. What's my condition going to be? So I drop down and select. For this one, I'm going to say subject includes. So, and then now I can put the words in. So if I just put in, if I look at this, it has Microsoft invoice. I'm going to put those words in it. So I'll say Microsoft invoice. Just leave it there. Now I could add another condition if I wanted, or go right to the action. What do I want to have happen? So I'm going to drop down and I want it to move into a folder. What folder is it going to be? Well, I'll drop down and this time I'll create a folder and I'm going to say Microsoft invoice, just like this, invoices, and hit save. So I have my condition, if I see something go through with this, and the action. And you can also see that we can add another action or we can have an exception to this as well. Now, if I save this, this will apply to all incoming future messages with this. But if I want to run the rule now based on all the messages that I already have with an invoice, I could choose this one and hit save. Because what's going to happen is it's going to go through my emails. If I look for Microsoft invoices, it cleaned up the past ones as well, and any future ones will go right to there. So creating these rules to filter incoming email will keep things clean for you. This next Microsoft Outlook tip is how to send your emails with a scheduled delayed delivery. You don't want to send it right away. You want to be able to craft your emails and have it sent out exactly when you want. Maybe it's different time zones, or maybe it's just the way you work. So let's say I've crafted this very important email here and I want to send it out to my team. If I don't want to send it right away, don't click send. Just do the drop down and schedule send. If you'll see here, they show different times if it was last chosen as a time to send out, but you can go and choose a custom time as well. So I could go pick a time, schedule what time I would like it to be. Maybe I want to come really early in the morning and then hit send. And you'll notice is it's not going to be in your sent items. It's going to go to your drafts. If I move over to my drafts, you'll see it right in here. If I click on it, there's a note here. It's a scheduled send. If I want to go through and edit, I can modify the email or send it now if I would like. But take advantage of crafting and sending later. Don't forget about setting up your auto replies. So whether it's a business trip or vacation, this will let people know you're unavailable. Let's go up to our view and then to view settings again. This time we're going to go under accounts and you're going to see that there's automatic replies. At this point, you can pick what account you want it to be connected to. Go ahead, turn this on. What's the dates that this is going to be for? So if you want specific dates, you could turn this on and then pick between certain dates and times. And you also have some options to block the calendar for this period, automatically decline new invitations for events, or decline and cancel my meetings during this period. So you decide if any of these are matching your needs. Here is where you're going to write your message. So let's say I have this message that I'm just letting people know that I'm taking a much needed break in here. And then I can also add on, is this going to be send replies outside the organization or only to contacts? So once you get everything kind of set up the way you want, go ahead and hit save. So now these are going to be sent for you during that time if someone sends you an email. If you want to go back to this at any time, remember it's under the accounts and we have our automatic replies and you can go ahead and turn it off and save it. The ultimate Microsoft Outlook tip I have for you here today that beats all the other ones, kind of like one tip to rule them all, is Copilot. If you have Copilot available to you, take advantage of it. I'm going to show you a few quick things that Copilot can do for you, but I'll come out with a more detailed video that I'll place up top in the card. Let's take a look at these tips. So if you're drafting an email, you can simply go up top to Copilot and draft with Copilot or even get coaching tips. Now I can go to the body, hit /, and I can go draft with Copilot, put in my prompt. Again, the more detail the prompt, the better, and generate. But it also allows you, once it's generated, you can do some customization from it. You can see the different suggestions, but you can keep it and it's there. Now, what I really like also is if I go to any email, Copilot's at the top, I can get a quick summary. So you can see to see how much time this can save you. Now, the thing I really like is if I go over to Copilot on the side here, this connects with my Microsoft 365 and different people in my organization. So here's an example here. So here's a prompt that they already have started. Stay informed. So what's latest from Kathy with the emails, chats, and files? So if I click on it, it goes down to my prompt. I can send it and it's going to go look through any of the different emails, different things sent from Kathy. And it will even put different links to the email. So right here, I could click on the different emails or edit them pages. You can see there's citing where the information came from. So it makes it easier to search your email using Copilot, but I can also ask things about it to sum up different emails, go searching through email calendar, and it will even have some different ideas for prompts. If I open them up, you can see all the different ones that you can go through, whether it be catch up, learn, create, ask. So Copilot is definitely a game changer inside Outlook. Watch for that video that I will have coming up shortly. I hope these tips that I showed you today about Microsoft Outlook will save you a lot of time. Do you have any other tips that you would like to share? Write them down in the comments down below. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next week with more tech tips and tutorials.